Intrusion 2021. This could have been half the time it was, and still have been just as effective. It really could have been. It really, really, really lagged at the well, most of it really, really, really lagged. All the action is near the end, and there's a lot of those in the dark scenes that I really hate. I don't know why so many movies do that. It's literally impossible to see anything, and it's like, why do you do this? But anyways, fortunately, there wasn't a lot of that. But yeah, deep dark secret. The husband's got a deep dark secret. Yeah, blah 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 blah. Anyways, 6 out of 10. Hypnotic 2021. I look dead. Dang, that light is not doing my skin any good. I look dead. Anywho, Hypnotic 2021. Woman sees a hypnotherapist and it has deadly consequences. This is kind of unique, but it's just, oh my God, it felt like it was 4 hours long. It just lagged and lagged and lagged, and I did not enjoy that, but it was passable to me. I got through it anyways. It was passable. I gave it a 5. It's kind of an interesting premise. I just wish it was executed a little bit better, and I wish it was more exciting. Shot Caller, 2017. This is a pretty interesting portrayal. It's pretty true to life portrayal too, of what happens when somebody makes a stupid mistake and ends up going to prison. Sometimes the institution turns you into a monster, turns a good person into a monster, and this is exactly what happens in this movie. It's a really good movie. Anyways, it's got lots of action. It's got lots of violence. It's got a really good story. And it's got a really good moral. 8 out of 10.